gift of faith. For me personally as a leader, one of the best friends in terms of a gift, a person that's come alongside me, whether it's on the stewardship board here at church or in ministry, so vital. Because it can be hard to be a leader. And there's a lot of critics sometimes, but the gift of faith has this godly optimism. Here's the working definition. The Spirit-given ability to see what God wants done and to believe. That's a key word you want to underline. To believe he will accomplish his will even if it seems impossible. Now, let's not confuse the gift of faith with saving faith. That is the trust that we place in Christ. Let's not confuse it with the fruit of the Spirit, this quality in our life. Let's not confuse it with what Paul says is the summation of the Bible's teaching, the faith, the doctrine that we hold to. This is a spiritual gift that is given to some, not to all. The foundation of this gift builds upon an understanding that our God is a great God, right? Who will accomplish all that he desires, all right? Because it's a gift of God, it's not something that we can generate. Oh, I'm just gonna believe it, I'm gonna get this gift, No, it's given, and when you have it, you have it. It's not about trying harder. It's not about being a possibility thinker, okay? It's a gift you've received or you don't have it. So here's the contribution. The contribution here is it gives the church this vision of a great God, right? And by that, the church is built up. It refreshes those who lead because it's not saying, like, this is impossible. We'll never be able to do it. It's like, you know what? With God, all things are possible. I believe that God is saying that we can do this. Let's continue to trust him. It strengthens us. It gives confidence. And it's going to stretch us. It's going to stretch us. It's uncomfortable sometimes to be around these people. So characteristics. Have a big view of God. Have courage to believe God even when others don't. So this is this idea of they're a big Godder. They've got a big view of God. Second, they have a quiet confidence that God's at work, that he's going to accomplish his purposes. Third, they have the ability to see beyond the present. The circumstance that we're facing right now to what God wants to do around the corner. That's what they're on about. They believe that all things are possible with God because they understand who God is, the creator of everything. They're people of prayer who pray often about these matters. There's some cautions though. Got to watch out for your pride. When what you see by faith becomes reality, you go, I told you so. What's wrong with you guys? What's wrong with them is they didn't have the gift of faith like you did. Praise God that you exercised it so that they too would come along for the ride. Be careful not to judge those who find it hard to believe. There's another caution. Make sure what you see is of the Lord and not your own dreams or desires. Or as a friend of mine says, some bad pizza last night where you go, you know, God told me. Be very careful about that. Like, I don't know what to say when you say, God told me we're supposed to plant 52 churches in the next 52 weeks. I don't know what to do with it. So when you have faith that comes alongside of a leader and the vision of the leadership that hopefully is more than one person, because the Bible definitely speaks about a plurality of leadership, then you're in check here, right? And so be careful about that, that it's not your dreams. It's what God has laid on your heart. So be available to God for what you believe that he's going to do. Don't just say, I believe God's going to do that. You guys go get him. No, you become a part of what God is going to do all to his honor and glory. Don't presume on God. Yes, God can do the impossible, but don't box him in, right? Don't hold to your gift of faith with complete humility here. I may be wrong. This is what I'm sensing. I know God can do that. I feel like he's saying we should trust him and go in this direction, all right? It reminds us of our responsibility, right? That we are to walk by faith. We may not have the gift of faith, but we're to grow in that, grow in our understanding of who God is, grow in greater confidence of him, whether we have the gift or not. So the next gift that we want to talk about is a gift that not only refreshes the giver, but the recipient. And it has all these wonderful kinds of boomeranging ripple effects. Check out the next gift as we talk about the gift of giving.